Well, the economy is starting to recover from the pandemic, but at a cost. The price of numerous items, from diapers to lumber to metal, just keeps increasing. The market seems to be struggling with the pace of recovery as well. Vanessa McElrath is the wealth management partner at MLNR Wealth Management. She's joining us to talk about inflation today. Good morning to you, Vanessa.
Hi, good morning, Ashley.
So we're seeing a lot of headlines about inflation due to the pandemic. Break this all down for us about what's happening.
Sure. We certainly can't deny that there's been recently rising prices, I mean, particularly with housing costs here in Austin. But I think as far as drivers, we can point to some supply chain imbalances left over from the pandemic. Obviously, the rebounding economy, and then also some of the massive fiscal accommodations as factors causing some of the inflationary pressures. But, you know, although we've started to observe some of these prices and wages rise recently, it doesn't necessarily mean that hyperinflation is a foregone conclusion or that it's going to be long lasting. You know, I think that there's some expectations that some of the supply imbalances from COVID will eventually work themselves out.
But it always feels like when prices increase, they don't ever go back down. In fact, we did a story about a family building a home and the cost of lumber was going to cost them nearly $100,000 more just because of the cost of lumber. Do you really think that these prices could go back down?
Not necessarily that they would go back down, but I don't think that they could continue to increase at the pace that they've increased recently. So basically prices have increased about 3% recently, and historically 3% has been pretty average. So not necessarily that they'll go down, and actually prices going down is deflation, which we don't want either.
You know, when we talk about the rate of inflation, obviously the cost of things is increasing, but people aren't necessarily getting paid more, especially as a lot of businesses are trying to rebound from the pandemic. So how do you as a consumer balance that and make sure you're using your money wisely?
Well, I think, you know, the biggest risk is obviously in the short term, there can be some problems of just trying to keep up. But from a long-term perspective, it's really important to try to preserve your overall purchasing power. Because again, as these prices of goods and services increase over time, it means that you can buy fewer of them with every dollar saved. So it's an erosion of the real purchasing power of wealth, and it's really crucial to try to keep up with that pace of inflation by growing your assets, at least at a rate that's greater than the inflation rate.
You know, a lot of people took up investing during the pandemic. What's your words to investors as we look at maybe lumbers or metals and things of that nature?
Sure. I mean, first and foremost, I think inflation isn't a signal to flee stocks. In fact, it's the very reason you want to own them in the first place, because over the long term, a diversified basket of stocks has probably been the most efficient hedge or protection against inflation over time. Now, you'll hear things like gold that's often touted as a good inflation hedge, but actually it's been one of the least effective inflation hedges one could have owned. For starters, it's just so incredibly volatile, much more volatile than a broad basket of stocks. And it has significantly trailed, let's say, the S&P 500 in terms of performance over the long term. So it just really isn't as effective.